Myself is Divya Bahel, Assistant Professor in Chemical Engineering Department at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. The subject that we are going to continue is Mass Transfer Operations 2. So in last lecture we studied about humidification, right? And we saw certain important definitions also which are related to your liquid and vapor phase, right? Because in humidification what is happening, that your liquid, okay, it is transferring into your gas in form of what? Water vapor. So that is your humidification, right? And we saw some important terminologies like dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, then your what is humidity, absolute humidity, saturation humidity, right? So now here important topic, important another definition here is specific enthalpy. So first of all, about your liquid vapor and gas system. See, the absolute value of enthalpy cannot be formed, okay? This thermodynamic properties like internal energy, specific enthalpy, okay? All these terms are calculated with respect to certain reference, right? So here also for your gas and water vapor system, you're calculating your enthalpy in relative to a reference temperature, okay? So for air water vapor system, you take the reference temperature as 2273 Kelvin, that is at your 0 degree Celsius. Okay, so you are taking that as your reference temperature. Now, so what is specific enthalpy here? That it is defined as the heat required for bringing 1 kg dry air and associated liquid water from initial temperature T0 to final temperature T at constant pressure. Okay, so you need to find your enthalpy at temperature T. Here T0 is your reference temperature. Okay, always at reference temperature, because what, 0 degrees Celsius is your reference temperature. Okay, your enthalpy at that temperature is always known. Okay, so with respect to that, at T temperature at which you have to find, you are calculating your enthalpy. So your formula is what? H is equal to CpB into T minus T0. Here CpB is what? It is specific enthalpy of your dry air. See, specific what? It means with respect to 1 kg, with respect to mass you are talking about. Okay. Similarly, what is CpA? It is specific enthalpy of your water. Okay. See, here directly we are not taking into account water and air system. Okay. Because specific enthalpy of your dry air and water is different. Okay. So that's why how you are defining. You are defining that heat required to bring 1 kg dry air plus water also. Okay. So here you can see that, of course, dry air only sensible heat has to be given. Okay. So your formula is what? CpB into T minus T0. Okay. Plus Y dash lambda. What is Y dash? It is the amount of water we are talking about. Okay. Which is to be, which is present in your dry air. Okay. Which is present together in your dry air, and finally you are getting your humid air. Okay, so Y dash lambda plus Y dash into CpA whole into T minus T0. Okay, so here first of all have a look. What is lambda? It is a latent heat of vaporization at T0 temperature. Okay, for 1 kg liquid. So your lambda is at T0 temperature, and you can see that Y dash CpA into T minus T0 is what? Sensible heat required for your water. Okay, at any temperature your water might be there. Sensible heat is what? To raise its temperature. Okay, and latent heat, what does it give? It is associated with phase change. Okay, from 100 degrees Celsius water to 100 degrees Celsius steam. Okay, so what is that? Phase change has been occur. Okay, so hence with your associated water, what you are taking into account sensible heat and latent heat. So finally your expression is what? Cs into T minus T0 plus Y dash into lambda. In last lecture we studied about what? Humid heat. So humid heat is what? CpB plus Y dash CpA. So your enthalpy formula is finally what? Cs into T minus T0 plus Y dash into lambda. So this is your specific enthalpy. Now the next topic is adiabatic saturation temperature. Okay, so what is this? This is a thermodynamic property of your moisture, right? So the definition is the temperature that the air stream could attain if it were allowed to become saturated adiabatically. Okay, adiabatically means no heat input is there, neither is your heat output. Okay, so here important point is that your enthalpy at inlet and outlet stream remains constant. So here you can see that at T1 position, what is T1? The temperature of your inlet dry gas. Okay, that at that temperature your enthalpy, whatever that is, that is same as equal to the of moisture. From you can see moisture is getting out of your adiabatic saturator. Okay, so enthalpy at that T2 temperature. So this is the relation of your enthalpies in your adiabatic saturation condition. What is T2 here? Your T2 is your adiabatic saturation temperature. Okay, so the setup is what? Here you can see that you are passing your dry gas in your adiabatic saturator. Okay, from the outlet you are getting what? Humid air. With the temperature is what? Its temperature is adiabatic saturation temperature. But the loss of water, okay, of course water is transferring into dry gas, so you have to compensate for that loss of water. So what you are doing, you are supplying the makeup water also, and the temperature of that water is what? That is at T2 temperature. Okay, so you are maintaining the condition here. So let's see, this is your adiabatic saturation. Here you can see that you are passing your unsaturated air. Okay, at dry bulb temperature, whatever dry bulb temperature it might have, you are passing it. Of course, as it is unsaturated, its relative humidity would be what? It is less than 100%. From the outlet, you can see that you are getting what? Your saturated air. It means relative humidity is what? 100%. And its outlet temperature is what? That is your adiabatic saturated temperature. Okay, so you can see that even the water in the system, that is what? At your adiabatic saturation temperature. So the air which you are getting, its outlet temperature would be what? T adiabatic saturation temperature. But that is at the outlet part, right? So here you can see that the loss of water, okay, as water is transferring into dry gas, you are having a constant supply of water also to maintain the water level. And the condition at which you are supplying your water, that is same which is present in the inlet of your saturator. Okay, so the temperature of water is what? Same here. Here you can see that the makeup water which you are supplying, its temperature would be what? Again T2 temperature. Right? So this is about your adiabatic saturator. This is a setup in which you can measure your adiabatic saturation temperature. Okay? So it is a very long insulated chamber. Why insulation? Because here what? Again, it is carried out adiabatically. No heat input is there or output is there. Right? So here important points about your adiabatic saturation temperature is that first of all you are allowing the gas to saturate. Here you can see that saturated air is obtained. Okay? So it means what? Partial pressure is equal to vapor pressure here. The quantity of unsaturated gas which pass through the chamber is small. Of course, you can see the unsaturated air which you are passing. Okay, the volume which it would be taking in the chamber, of course, it would be very small. Okay, your system is what? Inside the chamber. So inside that chamber, the air quantity is what? It is small. The equilibrium temperature attained by gas vapor mixture when it is adiabatically humidified, it is known as adiabatic saturation temperature. Again, note on the key point. It is what? It is an equilibrium temperature. Okay. So here humidity and temperature of air changes. Again, have a look here. Of course, the air which is going out, its temperature is different. Okay, dry bulb temperature might be there. And its humidity is different. Of course, you can see from it that relative humidity is what? Less than 100%. Whereas the air which you're obtaining outside, out of your instrument, okay, it is saturated, means your humidity has changed, okay, water has been transformed into it, and also the temperature of your air has also been changed. Now, the humidity attained by gas under equilibrium is saturation humidity and at adiabatic saturation temperature. So that saturation humidity, what is it? That is Y dash AS. Okay, see, I am applying dash over it. It means it is a saturated condition. Okay, no more water can be transformed now into air. Okay, so it is in your saturation condition. Now, here note down important point that the latent heat required for vaporization of water is provided by gas, which loses its sensible heat. Hence, the air cooled down. So here you can see that transfer of water is occurring into gas. But how it's occurring? So you can see that from water to transform from liquid phase to vapor phase. Okay, from liquid to gas, it has to convert its phase. So latent heat is required. Okay, so that is supplied by the air. Okay, as air is passing, so air is at high temperature than water temperature, right? So because of that, transfer of latent heat will occur. Okay, as latent heat is supplied by air. Okay, so what will happen? Air will lose that amount of heat. Now, as air is losing that amount of heat, hence it will cool down. Okay, so suppose your air is at 30 degrees Celsius, okay, and water is what? At suppose 20 degrees Celsius. So what? Air is supplying latent heat, and because of latent heat is supplied, your water, it will get converted into what? Vapor phase. And now what temperature difference has been created? Okay, sensible heat, 30 minus 20. So air will lose that amount of heat, okay, and then this way air will cool down. So here you can see the mechanism. Now equilibrium. Why equilibrium is achieved? See, because as limited amount of air is passed, after some time an equilibrium condition will be reached. Okay, no more further transfer of water can occur, because what, air is finite. Okay, continuous flow of air is not here, because in your system finite amount of air would be there, and so transfer of water would be into finite amount of air. Hence, after some point an equilibrium condition would be reached, and that is what your equilibrium temperature of your outlet air. So now, rate of liquid evaporated from your liquid pool, of course amount of water that is transferring, that is what, gs dash into y dash as minus y dash. Here gs dash is what, that is your mass flow rate of dry air, of course, because dry air is passing through it. Okay, hence we are taking what, mass flow rate of dry gas. Now, the rate of energy required for evaporation of liquid is what? That is m into lambda. Okay, what is mass flow rate of liquid here? That is your gs dash into y dash as minus y dash. And as rate of energy is there, hence here latent heat of vaporization will also come. So this is your rate of energy which is required. Okay, the above equation, what is it? That is the rate of liquid evaporated. Okay, amount of liquid which you are talking about. So, next is, but here note down that lambda, okay, that is lambda AS, that is latent heat of vaporization of liquid at adiabatic saturation temperature. Okay, the energy which is required, that is at adiabatic saturation temperature. Hence, at that particular temperature, you must have that data. Now, rate of sensible heat transfer by gas, that is what? Mass flow rate of gas, that is GS dash into CS, that is your humid heat, into T minus TAS. Okay, now as equilibrium condition is achieved, it means rate of liquid evaporated, that is equal to sensible heat transfer by gas. Okay, the amount of heat which is required, okay, latent heat which is required for liquid, that is supplied by what? That is supplied by gas. It transfer what? It transfers its latent heat. Okay, so hence y dash AS minus y dash into GS dash lambda is equal to gs dash into cs into t minus tas. Okay, so hence you get your final equation as t minus tas into y dash as minus y dash into lambda as upon cs. So this is what operating line of your adiabatic saturation line. Here cs is what, that is your humid heat. So as this is what equation of your straight line, and the slope is what, minus lambda as upon cs. Now, as you know, as this adiabatic saturation condition is there, hence enthalpy would be what? It will remain constant. Now, have some now the note down the difference between wet bulb temperature and adiabatic saturation temperature. What is wet bulb? It is steady state. Whereas in adiabatic saturation temperature, it is what? Equilibrium. Now, in wet bulb temperature, what you do? You pass bulk gas over your wet wick. Okay, finite amount of gas is not there. Your gas in bulk, it is flowing constantly through the wet wick. Whereas in adiabatic saturation temperature condition, right, in your chamber, finite amount of gas is there, small amount is there, okay, and it passes through what? It passes through bulk water. In wet bulb condition, saturation of gas is not happening, okay, whereas here in adiabatic condition, you are doing saturation, okay, your gas, it gets saturated. Now in both the cases, heat and mass transfer occur. But here note down, in wet bulb temperature, first, latent heat of vaporization is given up by water. Okay, your water gives up the latent heat of vaporization, thus it creates a temperature difference. But in adiabatic saturation condition, sensible heat transfer occurs from gas to water. Okay, sensible heat is transferring from gas. Hence, your gas cool down. And in wet bulb temperature, sensible heat transfer then occurs from gas to water. See, in wet bulb temperature, water is giving up its latent heat of vaporization. Okay, and then because of that, sensible heat transfer occurs from gas to water. After some time, a steady state temperature is attained, and that corresponding temperature is your wet bulb temperature. Whereas here, latent heat of vaporization is taken up by liquid and it vaporizes. Okay, So this is the difference between wet bulb temperature and adiabatic saturation temperature. The next topic is your vapor liquid equilibria for pure substance. So here you can see that your blue line, that is vapor pressure versus temperature curve. Okay, the region above is what, that is your pure liquid, whereas region below that blue line is your pure vapor. Now see, in humidification, everything is based upon the relation of vapor pressure and temperature, right? So here blue line, what does it show? It shows the boiling point and vapor pressure relation. Okay, see, the temperature corresponding to each pressure on this curve, that is your boiling point of liquid at that pressure. Okay, so hence here you can see that your vapor pressure is what, that is your function of temperature. As pressure changes on your y-axis, you can see that temperature also changes. So it shows you how boiling point is changing with your pressure. Okay, now the critical point is what, that now note distinction happens between liquid and vapor phases. It means now you are not able to differentiate between liquid and vapor. Some properties like density, viscosity of liquid and gases would be same. Okay, you won't be able to distinguish between what is liquid and what is vapor. Now, what is triple point here? All the three phases, solid, liquid and gas, they coexist here. So this was about your VLE. So that was for today's lecture. In next lecture, we will study about the cooling towers and what are the selection criteria of your cooling towers. So that was for today's lecture. Thank you.